I'm Representative Laurie Jinkins. I represent most of the city of Tacoma and the entire city of Ruston. It's the 27th Legislative District. I'm sitting here in the House Rules Room right now. This is one of what I consider to be kind of the little secret spots of the legislative building, and I've always wanted to do some videos of the secret spots, so I'm going to try and do a few of those this session, and this is one of those.
Well, rules room sounds very important and kind of mysterious. Can you tell us what exactly happens here?
Well, it is important and it is a little mysterious because I've never sat on the rules committee. So it's even a little mysterious to me. But there is a rules committee, and it's the last stop your bill makes before it's eligible to be voted on the floor. So when it comes out of the committees that hear the bills, it goes into the rules committee. That's a bipartisan committee, and the membership is appointed by each of the caucuses. And then you as a member have to lobby a member of the rules committee to pull your bill out of committee. And so I've spent a lot of time lobbying members to pull my bills and have had pretty good success. It's a different sort of committee because you don't have public hearings. The rules committee can't amend a bill. They just get to decide whether or not a bill is ready to come to the floor or not.
So how does one get to be on the Rules Committee?
Yeah, well, that's another kind of interesting thing here in Olympia. Both the Republicans and the Democrats in the House have a committee called the Committee on Committees. And I sit on the Democrats Committee on Committees, and we look at the schedule and member interests, and we're responsible for recommending to our caucus who to appoint to each of these committees. So you have to be appointed to the Rules Committee, and if you are elected, then you are on the Rules Committee. And there's Republicans and Democrats on it, so every bill that comes to the floor of the House has to have a majority of the Rules Committee vote to move it off out of the Rules Committee and be eligible for the floor.
So who gets to chair the Rules Committee then?
Yeah, the Speaker of the House of Representatives chairs the Rules Committee, and that's actually a historic factor. So whoever is the Speaker of the House will probably always chair the Rules Committee.
So tell us a little bit about what's on the walls here of the rules room.
So there's a picture of every single Speaker of the House of Representatives since the beginning of the state of Washington. And I think it's great to come down here in part because you may notice some similarities amongst them. We've only ever had white men be the Speaker of the House of Representatives. So that's something that maybe someday will change. We'll have to see.
So from what I'm hearing you say, the Rules Committee serves as a kind of check and balance along the way in the legislative process. Can you talk a little more about that?
As I said earlier, your bill only moves onto the floor of the House or is only eligible to be voted on the floor if the Rules Committee votes it out. So the Rules Committee compiles all of the bills that are passed out of all the different committees, whether it's health care or local government, state government, the Environment Committee, the Civil Rights and Judiciary Committee that I chair. They're taking all of these bills and then they're deciding what are the highest priorities to move onto the House floor.
Representative Jinkins, thank you for this peek behind the curtain.
Thanks, and I'm looking forward to giving people more peeks behind the curtain.